The Lightning are back home and ready for the challenge of taking on the Predators in a matchup of two teams at the top of the NHL food chain. And maybe a preview of coming attractions.
They've given up the first goal of the game in four straight games. You don't want to do that against a team that's as balanced as Nashville.
Nikita Kucherov in a hurry. Back to Stamkos shooting. And Saros with a stop there. Kucherov fires in front and it deflects off Mike Fisher.
One of the great things, and there are many of them, that Kucherov can do on the attack is you never quite know how he's going to manufacture passes. But he loves this one. Go behind the net and throw it out on the short side. Now both Miller and Stamkos know exactly what he's capable of. This one is set up perfectly.
Tampa Bay's had the power play goals in five straight games. There's a shot by Stamkos that stopped in front as Saros had a look at that one. Here's Kucherov closing in, looking for Stamkos. Recovers the puck. Turns away from the veteran Mike Fisher, but gave the puck to him. And now steaming ahead, it's Hartman racing toward Vasilevsky. Got it on goal, a save. And we get the whistle from Morton and a holding penalty against Victor Hedman. One he had to take there. And there goes the power play chance.
Fisher's pretty smart. He puts a little bit of pressure on Stamkos, and the pass is blind and not very good. And Victor Hedman does what he has to do, but he doesn't give up a penalty shot. So Hartman, who protects the puck, doesn't get much of a chance away.
Girardi at the point works against Forsberg, and he sends it ahead. Johansson joined on the rush here by Smith. He scores! Ryan Johansson looked one way, fired back the other, and it's Nashville that opens the scoring.
The Lightning are aggressive at the blue line, and Dan Girardi gets caught in along with the forwards. McDonough does what he can, trying to fake that Johansson would maybe dish the puck off early, comes over, closes on him, and then fades back away. But because he's a right-hand shot, Johansson attacking on the left wing side, when he takes a look and stops up, he's got a beautiful angle to shoot.
Hartman picked up at the deadline from the Blackhawks. And now we got Fiala dumped by Cirelli. Closing in, there's a shot saved by Vasilevsky. Two saves, make it three for Andre Vasilevsky. Turning, it's Josi shooting, and it's deflected off to the corner. Salamaki in for Fisher. Poked away by Coburn.
Vasilevsky has to make three big saves. The first one is on him. Second one, you got to get somebody there. The third one, you can't give up chances. Lots of bodies back there. Got to play man on man.
Around to Stamkos, now to Hedman. Stamkos with it. Back to Kucherov. Miller parked near the front of the net where he's become very comfortable in his power play. Killorn back to Hedman. Thought about going to Stamkos. Now to Kucherov walking in, fake shoots, and it's deflected off the glass.
Here's a shot by Kucherov. Watch this go off his mask.
Point controlling that draw back to Strahlman. Johnson tips it in. Matty Gourde right on top of Ryan Ellis. Frees up the puck. Here's Point around the net. Catches up to it. Trying to lose Johansson. And Johnson fires. Saved there by Saros. Said he might have taken that off the mask, but kept it under control.
The change of direction that he can do and the interchanges with Gourde and with Tyler Johnson, that's what gives him the chance. Not messing around there. Getting the puck to the net, getting a shot. Yanni Gourde right there for a possible rebound. The Lightning shading to him a little bit. That opens up Ryan Ellis for two one-timers.
Forsberg cuts to the middle and shoots, deflected. They score! It deflected off the Lightning defender and squeezed through on Vasilevsky. And Nashville now has a 2-0 lead.
Forsberg, who's got some skills and he has some penetration, that's a key here in this play. He's able to get right through the middle, down almost to the hash marks. But as you see, he's actually trying to make a pass there. Went off the leg and the shaft of the stick of Anton Strahlman, and you can see how it surprised and handcuffed Vasilevsky. Just can't quite get the pads together.
Girardi steps up, they work it free down to Turris. Diving, sliding play there by McDonough, broke it up. Turris looked to have a great scoring chance. Vasilevsky a long distance. Stopped there on Boteto.
Ryan McDonough with an outstanding play defensively as the Nashville Predators make the play to the outside and then back into the middle and catch a seam there. McDonough coming up with a fantastic defensive play here against Kyle Turris. Everybody else had been covered, but if Palat hadn't hustled to come back when he did, Ellis gets a chance.
Cirelli busts out of a pack, finds Johnson shooting, saved by Saros, and he covers it up as he slid way out on the angle to stop Tyler Johnson.
Watch through the neutral zone and top of your screen, line change, Tyler Johnson. Heads up play by Cirelli. Sees him coming. Tyler Johnson fresh off the bench. They don't catch up to him. Cirelli's got his head up, puts it on the tape. Although this puck did bob a little bit. And I think that Fisher might have got a stick on it at the last second as well. Watch the left side of your screen. There's the line change. You see Nashville doesn't notice right away, but Fisher does, comes back with momentum. But Tyler Johnson didn't get all of that one. I think Fisher's stick got in there.
Matt Irwin, the former Shark, briefly a member of the Bruins. And here's Cirelli hopping on a errant pass. Palat with a shot. That's knocked down in traffic as Cirelli and Irwin were battling. Austin Watson caught up to by Cirelli. Bet in front. Palat shoots. The Lightning get one back. Down 2-1.
Cirelli, Killorn, and Palat have been dynamic in this game and early on in this second period, and it finally pays off. Excellent forecheck. There's Killorn. Turns the puck over. Instant attack because Cirelli's in good position. Get it to Palat. Stay on it. Cirelli and Palat, use your wheels. Stay on top of it. Cirelli with puck pursuit. Another turnover by him. Palat got up from falling down. Got to the front of the net. Cirelli turns it over. Strowman to the middle of the ice. And Palat with a shot off the heel of the glove of Saros. And the Lightning are back in it.
Sergachev. Now point. Winding. Firing. Directed on goal. As Palat got it on net, and Saros the stop.
Braden Point has his head up, and there's Palat. Palat does get a stick on it, but Saros does a good job of getting close to him. The puck doesn't get any elevation to get up and over him.
Kucherov gains the line, makes the play to Palat, kept the play moving to Hedman. There's a drive, and it hit Callahan. Fired on goal by Palat. A save by Saros.
Puck retrieval again. Palat so good at it. There's the pass and the shot. And then Callahan, who was in front of the net, ended up taking the brunt of that one.
He's got Parkett in front. Callahan trying to lose Smith. Coburn across for Girardi. He's got to back off now with Forsberg there to take it. Philip Forsberg on the off wing. Ducks inside. Scores! Philip Forsberg with a quick move has made it a two-goal lead for Nashville again.
Forsberg's got some slick moves, and he just places this puck right in between the stick and the feet of Girardi. Forsberg has already made his play, and once he's able to retrieve it on the other side of Girardi's stick, he makes a nimble little play to knock it back on the short side against Vasilevsky.
Oh, Lightning forwards are up around the center red line, and that was the outnumbered attack for Nashville.
Long pass, and it's on target. Smith shoots, he scores. And Nashville now leads 4-1.
Smith, who's been really valuable to them, both offensively and defensively, scoring some timely goals.
Chips it in, 8 to go. Irwin a clear to center ice. And Ryan Callahan's going to just hold on to it at center ice, drop to McDonough, and this one is over. The Predators come into Amboly Arena playing the second half of a back-to-back. They got embarrassed last night, 7-4, and they kind of rope-a-doped it a bit for the first two periods, but made a couple of plays to go up 2-1. And then they took control in the third, really dominated play in the final 20, and they win it by a final of 4-1.